Good morning, everybody. It's Monday morning, and Helene and I have taken a couple of days off, and we're up in the beautiful mountains of the Drakensberg just for a couple of days and enjoying our time together. But all these mountains around me remind me of the theme that we've been talking about recently. We've been talking about moving those mountains that Jesus said that we can move with just a faith the size of a grain of a mustard seed. And we have so far been looking at things like the mountain of failure, the mountain of the future, the mountain of the fear that we have of being found out, and the fear of rejection, and all these fearful mountains that we have. Today I'd like to hit a really big peak in this mountain range of this fear, and that is the fear of death. I think there's not one of us that would be overly confident enough to think that there wasn't an element of fear in every one of us. And I guess at a time that is appropriate, we need to acknowledge some of these issues that we are fearful of. I get to do a lot of funerals, and it's always a sad thing, but it's a great opportunity to do two things for people like me. First thing is, the purpose of a funeral is to bring comfort to those who are grieving, and also to bring words of challenge, because there is no greater opportunity to share the love of God and the compassion of Christ than at a funeral time, and how that should impact each of our lives. And so really it's a matter of comfort and challenge. And I suppose today I'd like to take some of the thoughts that maybe I've shared over the course of many, many funerals, and see if I can't do just that today. Now, let's talk about comfort today. One of the greatest comforts that we have when we come up against the mountain of this thing called a death is the great comfort that we need, first of all, to see it for what it is. Because I think we've been conned to think that death is something that I don't think the scripture suggests that it even is. You see, we, through human eyes, see death as the end. God sees it as a beautiful beginning. We see it as something morbid, and God sees it as something glorious. I guess it's something like seeing a different perspective from maybe a different angle. Now, I'm fortunate enough we can't see it today because there's so much mist around, but there are mountains around, and there's one particular mountain called Cathedral Peak up here in the Drakensberg. And I'm very familiar with what Cathedral Peak looks like from the side that I have seen it most often. But from where we are here, we're looking at Cathedral Peak from the other side, and it looks completely different. And I could arrogantly argue to say, that's not Cathedral Peak. That doesn't look like Cathedral Peak at all. And yet I would be clearly wrong. The thing is, I'm looking at it from the other side of the mountain. And I wonder if that isn't a little bit what death is like as well. From which side you see it, from this side it looks morbid and it looks like the end. But from the other side it's the same thing, but it looks like something completely, completely different. We have to get a better perspective of what this thing called death is all about. Now, David, who we've been looking at, and Saul, who we've also been looking at, have some great ideas on sharing perspectives on death. Let me take you to David's one. David says that death is just a shadow. That's interesting. He says, Psalm 23, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I can't think of a scripture that has helped me on the subject of death more than this one. Death is just a shadow. Now, a shadow can't hurt you. It could look scary. It could look frightening. But a shadow has no ability to hurt you. And David said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil. For God is with me, his rod and his staff, they comfort me. But the thought that death is but a shadow is very helpful. The Apostle Paul, in his writings, he talks about death being like a sting and painful, but it can only happen once from a bee, then the bee dies. He says death is like a tent. He says death is like this thing that we're living in here, this body that we spend so much time trying to look after and make it look as good as it can. And he says, it's just a tent. It's just a tent. He says, a tent is a temporary dwelling place. You don't want to live in a tent forever, do you? Because the real thing is still yet to come. And he says, death is like taking the tent down. You've done your bit. You've been in the tent. It's done, it's dusted, it's fit. We're taking the tent down so you could go on to live in the real thing. I suppose when you look at David and these great spiritual giants, I have a perspective as well. I see death almost like being a bully. I remember at school being there were a couple of guys that I was really scared of, and they would bully us. And every time I saw them, I would be afraid. And death is like that. It's just a bully. It threatens you. It can't really do anything to you. It can't really hurt you. It just looks ominous, and it looks rather threatening. Now you say, well, how do these people have this view of death? Well, I want to suggest you've got to have spiritual eyes. If you're going to look from another perspective and look at it from the other side, you've got to develop spiritual eyes to be able to see death for what it is. Now, there's a great story, and you know it well, and we've spoken about it a number of times. In the scripture of Elisha, this Old Testament prophet who was being chased by the king, and the king had found him in a city called Dothan. And Elisha had a servant called Gehazi. And in the morning, Gehazi went up onto the wall of the city, and in with shock, he ran back to Elisha and said, Elisha, we're dead. We're as good as death. The armies have surrounded the city. And Elisha was completely unpanicked. And he looked at the servant, then he looked up to heaven, and he prayed a simple prayer. He simply prayed this, Lord, won't you open his eyes, his spiritual eyes? And suddenly, in Gehazi's mind, his spiritual eyes were open, and he saw, man, it's magnificent. And he made the first declaration, greater is he who is with us, Elisha, than he who is outside the walls. And you're going to have spiritual eyes to be able to see that. And when we look through death, at death, through physical eyes, not very attractive. It looks very painful, and it looks very ominous. But when you have spiritual eyes and you look at the same thing, but from the other side, you'll see something completely different. I hope that over the course of the next couple of days, you're going to get this, and hopefully it'll be true. But guys, have a great day. So glad to hear that church went well on Sunday. Matt, you're a star. Thank you, my boy, for preaching. You're a good kid. And God bless you guys. Have a good day. Bye.